Hello and welcome to episode 185 of the Flight Sim Historian. For this episode, we are going to be looking at the Republic XF-91 Thunderceptor. The Thunderceptor was an American prototype mixed propulsion interceptor, first flown on the 9th of May of 1949, and it broke Mach 1 in December of 1951, becoming the first American fighter aircraft to exceed Mach 1 in level flight. The aircraft, as you can see here, let me change the view, has an inverse tapered wing, which made it more stable in a stall than a conventional swept wing. The first prototype of the aircraft is on display at the National Museum of the Air Force in Dayton, Ohio. The second prototype was destroyed in an engine failure incident in 1951, the tail melting off just 90 seconds into the flight. It was rebuilt with a butterfly tail similar to the Beach Bonanza, flown for a while in that configuration, and then used as a training sim, and then was unceremoniously scrapped. The XF-91 is powered by a single General Electric J-47 turbojet engine with a power output of 5,200 pounds of thrust, as well as four reaction motors XLR-11 rockets with power outputs of 1,500 pounds of thrust each. The maximum speed of the aircraft is 984 miles per hour, has a range of 1,170 miles, and a service ceiling of 55,000 feet. So the model we are using today is a brand new model from Uenoshing, I believe, if I'm pronouncing it right. He's from Japan. This is a freeware model. It was released yesterday on flightsim.com. Alright, let's turn the sound on. And it has a wonderfully detailed virtual cockpit. Now, not everything works in the cockpit, but sure does look nice. All right. And we are rolling. Mach 1.38 at 40,000 feet.
Mach 1.29 at 50,000 feet. We have an Airbus that is several miles below us. We are at over 55,000 feet, and we are still going a little bit over Mach 1. We are going to be turning back towards Edwards Air Force Base. And I am going to do a low speed or low altitude, high speed pass of the Edwards Tower. We're over Mach 1.5. Mach 1.7 is our speed as 27,500 feet. Mach 1.8. We are close to 26,000 feet. Now we're below 26,000 feet. Still Mach 1.8. Okay, lesson learned. The airplane's controls do not react at above 600 knots. Flaps are coming down. Knots. Knots. anyway. Yeah, I cannot say enough good things about this aircraft. I mean, one, it's free. Two, it's from my favorite time period of aviation history, and that would be the right after World War II ended, running up to the Vietnam era, you know, late 1940s to, you know, the 1960s. And it does look really, really good. I'm gonna park it over here next to these F-16s. Alright, let's shut this baby down. And that, folks, is the Republic XF-91 Thunderceptor. This has been the Flight Sim Historian, and we are done for this episode.